Tuesday, November 30th, 6 to 10 o'clock at the Anaheim White House. Again, that's the Bruno's restaurant, so you can donate on site, drop off pasta and sauce. Donate. We've got a lot coming up in the 5 o'clock hour. I'll tell you about that in a minute. But we just mentioned Jeff Bezos and this weird, weird country we have where guys almost all by themselves at the beginning create a tremendous company. And then people get mad at them for being successful. You see that with Jeff Bezos, Bill Gates, Elon Musk, the guys who want Apple, Steve Jobs, everybody is like the fifth off the game. And so, obviously, almost everybody is hearing from Amazon. It's been dozens of times a year. So, he started it. He's got the big ownership stake and all the stock. Of course he's going to get really good. So what? You didn't do it. What did you do? The guy's been working at it for 25 years. David, go look up the photos on Google of Jeff Bezos starting out. He's got a card table and a rented garage. A card table in a rented garage, and he's got a little vinyl banner that says Amazon behind it. Right, so that's what he's been doing for 25 years. But he's even pissing off other rich people. And I don't get this story. There was a big fancy fundraising gala in Los Angeles over the weekend at the Pacific Design Center in West Hollywood, Saturday night. A-list event. Called Baby to Baby. I don't know what the charity was about. But he and his girlfriend, Lauren Sanchez, went to it. And apparently the crowd wasn't happy. Because when it came time to donate, he only donated $500,000. $500,000. Said one insider, everybody was waiting for him to donate something. But he didn't. And then a little later, he donated $500,000. Well, that is something. What do you mean? There was an audible groan in the room. People groan? What the hell?
It could have been 500 million.
Well, this writer for Page Six, the New York Post gossip column, reached his life stream of being a gossip. This is what I love. A little worm making $20,000 a year. He's getting all self-righteous about Bezos. Claims that Bezos makes $142,000 a minute. So he makes 4 and 5 minutes. Then he donated. The event honored Vanessa Bryant with its Giving Tree Award because she supported the charity. She paid tribute to Kobe, and she also talked about her daughters. And then the list of all the actors and actresses who showed up there. I mean, I just don't get it. Anybody who drops $500,000, be happy you got the $500,000. People don't have to get anything. They get $500,000, that's a big win. And why don't you go start Amazon? And then you can get more money. We come back, we're going to talk to a Border Patrol agent who's trying to run a coffee shop. Another guy is just trying to run a small business. Now, he's getting the trouble from the community. They don't want to drink his coffee because he's a border. Talk to him. That's next. Oh, and it's 5:30, Gloria Allerton. And she is representing the script supervisor who is claiming that Alec Baldwin intentionally shot that gun. And he didn't have to because there was no scene that was being filmed anytime soon involving that guy. Pretty startling details there. It was a press conference. Talk to Gloria about her client. We come back. John Kenta, Deborah Marquez, News, Kfi Am 640.
If it doesn't affect you, we're not interested.
Kfi.
KOSP HD2.
Los Angeles, on time.
Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
I'm Deborah Mark, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom, LA County Sheriff. In a way, this is if you ride a subway, bus, or train in the county, you should be worried.
The sheriff says if the MTA board has its way, his deputies and other cops will be kicked off the buses and trains. In a way, that says the county has the fourth highest crime rate in the country for violence on mass transit, including murders, assaults, and rape.
This is the level of carnage. It is occurring on the train. And I think the
the group to whatever plans they have to removing law enforcement. That's like a suicide pact.
The FDA is considering doing away with the $75 million law enforcement contract in place of private security and nonprofits that would provide homeless and mental health services. Gregory, KFI News.
The news is brought to you by MyCalChoice.com, a new free filing diversion program in LA County trained to hold young people accountable without the criminal record. Central LA Youth Services Executive Director Jessica Ellis says, through the program, people hurt by crime have a voice in the resolution and restitution.
We have been Central LA Youth Services, the rearrest rate cut by 50 to 70%, and restitution completion rates for victims were manufactured higher. 166
LA County DA George Gaston says each program is individually tailored with input from the people hurt by the crime. He says the program will also address racial disparities in the justice system. A crew member on the movie set where Alec Baldwin accidentally shot and killed a cinematographer has filed a lawsuit seeking punitive and financial damages.
Script supervisor Mandy Mitchell's lawsuit takes aim at actor Alec Baldwin and other producers of the movie. Mitchell, who was standing next to the late Helena Hutchins when the accident happened, recounted the deadly incident.
They had some kind of large oxygen balloon thing on her face, and her left hand was on her stomach. It is true.
The lawsuit filed by attorney Gloria Allred alleges that 60 protocols surrounding guns were ignored. The suit also alleges that no rehearsal had officially started for the scene when the accident happened, and that even if one was, the scene didn't call for the firing of a gun. Blake Strolley, KFI News.
John will be talking to Gloria Allred after the news at 5:30. California's independent legislative analyst's office has predicted the state will have a $31 billion budget surplus next year. The surplus is so large, the office estimates it will exceed a constitutional limit on state spending by more than $14 billion. The governor and state lawmakers might have to cut taxes, spend more money on schools and infrastructure, or give rebates to taxpayers. Federal health officials say there has been an increase in people who are vaccinated against COVID-19 having to go to the hospital for serious symptoms. CDC Director Rochelle Walensky says the protection from the vaccine is starting to wear off for many people, but she says people who have chosen not to get the shot are still the most at risk.
Those who are unvaccinated continue to be more likely to be infected, more likely to be in a hospital, and more likely to have severe complications from COVID-19.
Walensky says people should definitely try to get the vaccine or booster shot if they're trying to travel or get together for the holidays. And lawyers for Kyle Rittenhouse in Wisconsin have asked the judge to declare a mistrial before the jury reaches a verdict. They say they got an inferior copy of a key video from prosecutors who argued the jury saw the highest quality version during the trial and it was played without objection. Defense attorney Corey Shirofsky says they would have approached things differently had they received the higher quality video.
We can sit here all day and say it's been played. We didn't know there was another version. How is that reasonable?
The judge did not immediately make a decision. Rittenhouse is charged with shooting three men during a protest in Kenosha. Two of them died. Deliberations will continue tomorrow. We have a crash on the 210 in Monrovia. On the eastbound side, coming up on Myrtle, this wreck has been cleared out of lane, so watch out because it's a very slow drive getting out of Pasadena. The lane's leaving the 134 freeway beyond the scene of the crash at Myrtle. The drive remains heavy ahead as you roll towards Citrus. Let's head out to industry with Michael Bryan, KFI in the Sky, sponsored by injury attorney, superwoman, superlawyer.com.
Look, that drive is a 605, just a little past the 60. Looks like the earlier accident there did clear out of lane. Looks like all clear, but still suffering way back towards the 105. In fact, almost road crash. Not so rosy on the southbound side of the fence either. The southbound 605, rolling up there just about the 60. From the 60 through the 5, much of that is bumper to bumper. Continue of the 5. 5 southbound, you're on the brakes there from East LA Interchange, well through Downey. And another little pocket out of Norwalk is going on fire. Injured in accident, visit superwoman, superlawyer.com. Mike O'Brien, KFI in the Sky.
KFI in the Sky. Hope to get you there faster. I'm in for Martinez.
Well, you heard me talk about my friends at Sunday and how they can sell your home fast without any repairs, without the hassle of dealing with showings, realtors, cleaning, or making up for it. Now Sunday has made the process even easier for those who want to sell a property fast. Contact Sunday for your free no-obligation cash offer. They're going to visit your property, take photos, and do a 3D walkthrough. They'll package your property details and send it to the thousands of local investors in your database who are actively looking to buy property. The average homeowner receives 12 offers on their property. It's quick and easy. Plus, you can close in as little as 10 days, or you have the flexibility to close in months. They can even give you a $20,000 cash advance, which will help with moving costs when you sell on Sunday. Go to Sunday.com, S-U-N-D-A-E.com, or phone them, 825-OFFER. Get a free, no-obligation cash offer at Sunday.com, S-U-N-D-A-E.com. Sunday's California licensed real estate broker, GLE license number 020-8898.
Again, we've done everything we can to keep our kids safe, happy, and healthy during this pandemic. From finding the best face mask, to making sure their hands are clean. And now we have the best tool to help keep them even safer. The most important thing we can do is vaccinate our kids to protect them against COVID-19. Vaccines have been proven safe and effective for children 5 and up. But talk to your parents. So visit myturn.ca.gov to find a vaccine near you. Brought to you by the Vaccine Department of Public Health.
Oh,
I'm
Jim Mumble.
Thank you.
long let these groups be going. Really, really, really long. And it's hard to defend yourself against it. Jeff, thanks for coming on.
No, thank you for having me. I really appreciate it.
All right. Jeff Rambo there. All right, we got some more coming up. $1,000 to give away in a minute. Deborah Mark has news.
A cook supervisor who was supposed to call 911 when a cinematographer was killed on the set of Alec Baldwin's movie Rush has sued the movie's producer. Non-tenured faculty at the University of California have reached a five-year labor deal, which
is a step ahead for their best life.
Online UC schools that was set to start today. Two of the men found guilty of the assassination of Malcolm X during the civil rights era are expected to have their convictions
Watch your fuel savings pile up in our stores.
That's great.